Good evening and welcome to Bloody Fox Gaming. Tonight I will start playing a new game. Oh, it's an old game, I think from 2013 or 2014. It is free on Epic Games Store for the next 6 days. You just need to have an account, click on the game, and it's yours. In this game, you can play as any nation from the year 1444 until the year 1836, and the last starting date you can start play is 1792. You can start playing in any year between 1444 and I think 1792. I will start playing as Muscovoy. I go to form Russia. First enemy we are going to take down is Novgorod. Okay, let's play. I'm not going to play in Iron Man mode because on Epic Games there is no achievements. There are no achievements, so let's play in normal mode. Usually I'm playing Crusader Kings 3 with achievements, but that game is on Steam. First order of business is to take down Novgorod. Anytime now? Okay. At the end of the 1444, Russia is divided into a number of principalities, all of whom have for a long time lived in the shadow of the Tatar Golden Horde. The Tatars have been ever present in Russian politics, collecting tribute, taxes, and acting as kingmakers in the Christian states. While the Grand Principality of Moscow is not the oldest of these states, it has recently grown to be the strongest. Located in the relatively fertile Opoye, Moscow has a strong internal economy than many of other principalities. More importantly, their princes have often acted as collectors for the crowns of the Golden Horse, making their princes both relatively safe and able to grow rich. Since the crushing defeat of the Golden Horde at the hands of the Timurid armies, their empire has fractured into a number of successive states. The core of their empire, the Great Horde, is still a strong power in its own right, but it's fraught by internal struggles and has been unable to project much power over the Russians. Moscow has made good use of this power vacuum, expanding their control over the other principalities rapidly. I think you have like 4 or 5 vassals. In the north, the Republic of Novgorod has colonized much of the White Sea coastline, securing developable waterways and source of fur, the soft gold of the north, and caste. To the west, Grand Duchy of Lithuania and the Kingdom of Poland are doing what they can to assume the leadership over Russia, asserting authority over most Ruthenian land, as well as constant fracturing the politics of the free Russian states in the north. If the Tatar yoke could be crushed once and for all, there is also the vast expanse of Siberia, full of untold riches and dangers. If the many Khanats, natives, and the nature itself can be overcome, there is no limit how rich a united Russian state could grow. First order of business, we need to take down Novgorod. We have separatists. Okay, Novgorod. Let's choose Lithuania. And let's go with Kazan. I'm not going to declare war on Denmark. Okay, we have the rivals. We need to increase the control of the crown lands. Let's see, boyars. Novgorod trade node. Right now it's 21. I always go with that. Thank you. if the wealth is over 50%, then it should seize the land, and it should keep on doing that. I'm getting 3, maybe I could go with one advisor, 645 per month. You're getting 3 per month, and your vessel administration, diplomatic and military skill are added. Missionary strength, yearly prestige. Saver 0. Sweden is not independent. Okay, what are we going to integrate first? Relations, improve relations, okay. How many diplomats do we have? One. Now we have 2 traders. Okay, where are we going to send them? Oh, they're already working. Okay. Let's unpause the game and let's attack the Novgorod. Oh, 11th of December, okay. Okay, we got the claims now on territories. All these missions are new. Horizon is against us. Now let's lower the speed a bit. Okay, we have 5,000 south, maybe tag that. Okay, Oxide, they are retreating. Looking in the north, they are spreading their troops. They're going south again. Yeah, we are chasing them. Okay, can you catch them finally? Thank you. No, we still didn't catch them. Finally. Okay, we got the war score. Looks like we're going to lose that battle. We need to wait for that army and then attack again. Oh, should I start from the beginning? I don't know. Of course, we are losing troops now. Can you catch their army? Looks like we can. Hey, Kusuro, good evening, mate. Trying out your open results. Started as Muscovoy. Trying to take out Novgorod first. Yeah, why don't you go this way maybe? You don't lose troops because crossing over enemy territory, you know, that would be really helpful. Okay, I see enemy army. And again, you are going north, of course, you are going north. Okay, looks like he'll open gates here. Increase pensions, national tax modifier. Or minus fund stability. Great. Let's increase stability here. No, where is it? At what year did you start? 1444, like 2 years ago. Novgorod had one ally, Ryzen. I destroyed their army first. How is the sound? Is it okay? I have like 5 vassal states helping out with the occupation. New trade research is heretical. Accept their demands, ignore them. Man. Prestige minus 3. Can you capture their capital? Okay, let's move second army. Okay, looks like music is not too loud. I did lower the sound volume to like 50%. Okay, it's 54. Let's try to destroy that army. And then we can try to take all territories which borders Sweden and Lithuania, so that no one else can attack them. And then in second war I can take the rest of the territory. Hey, hello Ahmed, good evening. This game is free on the Epic Store. So I decided to play it tonight. I did play it before, but pirate version like 3 years ago. So I'm relearning how to play this game. A grand strategy game made by Paradox. We start playing as Moscow, attacking Novgorod. Did you play any games today, Ahmed? Okay, I'm trying to cut their army so that I can finish this war. Poor score is 54%. They're moving north, it's March. Okay, let's move north. Come on, catch them, of course, no? Okay, finally, we have the battle. Although we have declared war on Ryzen. Decline, it's a good sign. They're sending peace offer, that means they're going to lose the war. Let's win this battle and take the rest of their territory. Okay, complete estate agenda. I need to take Odoyev next. Where is Tver? We are not allied. I need to take them also. But Odoyev is more important because they are bordering Lithuania, so that Lithuania can declare war on them. Thank you. There was jousting tournament forward to glory. Moral arms, with some administrative power and ducats. Yeah, why not? One last tournament. Okay, we have 3,000. Oh, there they are, 6,000 troops north. Okay. And Ryzen has 3,000 troops again. Okay, I have 9,000, they have 6.6, maybe I can win the battle. Okay, I have 35% of siege in Oki. Percent almost done. Let's see. A water shortage, still 35%. Power zero. Okay, maybe try to avoid the combat. Poor government policy. Minus 25% government reform progress. Okay, 84%. Yeah, I have no diplomats to send. Okay, let's cancel here. So can I take promise? Maybe because I didn't have the claim on the promise when I declared the war. Yeah. Looks like I made a mistake of some kind, I can't take any territories. Okay then. Looks like I need to start from the start. Okay, let's start from the beginning. I don't know what is the problem. I have the claim, but I can't take the territory because that was not the war for claim. So okay, whatever. I start again. Okay, let's start again. I need to get a claim first somehow. I don't know why don't I have a claim. Okay, let's start again. It's not that I have many viewers, so accumulate can get you any land. Okay. Samara area. And where is the territory? Probably not in Novgorod. Of course it's not. What do you want? Yeah, let's go with that and seize land. Let's see, administrative power, national taxes 10%. Let's go with that. Lithuania and Kazan. I don't get how I wasn't able to take the territory. I need to fabricate the claim. I don't have the claim. Yeah, we don't have the claim on the rest of the Russian lands. So yeah. Okay, let's start again. It's speed 5, royal marriage. Okay. No, they're allied with Lithuania. Looks like I can start again. I don't know how I wasn't able to take territories. Great, now I need some. And now I can take core. How did I not have that option previous time? Okay, let's train more troops. Okay, you are now allied with nobody. Okay, that's much better. Now we can take the core. Let's see, 2000. And move it here. Let's try again. Oh, first war is very important. You need to take out the territory. I made a mistake. When you sign the truce, you can't declare war on them for another 10 years. So that is the reason I started again. Velsk, where is that located? Okay. Okay, I see enemy army. Let's try to destroy their army first. Allied with Herzegovina, allied with Bosnia, allied Austria and the Palatinate, Poland, allied with Bohemia. Yeah, this time let's try to take enemy army first. Are we going north? Yeah, they are going north. Let's attack, mission fulfilled, attack Novgorod, now kill the claims on all territories, okay, we learned something new. Of course they move their troops there. And we'll have the penalty, crossing penalty. Join the fight today. Thank you. Okay, we have 9%. We need to capture Novgorod and we need to destroy their armies. Okay, we have minus 2, let's see, war taxes will cost 2 military power per month while at war until cancelled. Well, what can we do? Let's do it, we're in minus 2. And we have taken our own automatically, great. Okay, war taxes, now we are losing 0.50. That's not too bad. With that one, that should be enough for the war. Novgorod. 23% it's right now. Now we are getting plus 0.70 gold per turn, though per month. Okay, let's take out Novgorod. 550 war score. Okay, they managed to escape. Let's continue pursuing them north. Okay, we got 3% war score. Okay, I see enemy army. Let's go there. One army will stay and besiege their capital, Novgorod. Second army will pursue their units and destroy them. And the rest of my allies should occupy the rest of the territory. I have open gates. Let's see. Moving in that direction. Of course, now you are going north. So okay, go back. Stability. I'm going to be needing a lot of administrative power for the new territories. Your vassals, you can. Annex, okay, 99%, this war is over. Let's now go. Okay, looks like I'm back. There was some problem with the Radeon encoder. Okay, looks like stream is working fine. I'm sorry for a few of my viewers who are still with me. Okay, we have corruption. How to decrease corruption? Inflation 2%. Improve relations, then we can see the clear war. We don't have a Custis belly against them. Vazal Moscovoy, Livonian Order, Riga, Teutonic. Thank you. Let's see, we are getting 0.05. We could lower the army maintenance for now. Okay, morale of the army, reinforce speed. Let's go morale of the army. Trade efficiency, okay. Age 32. Okay, what do we need? Novgorod, Tver, Yaroslav, Ryazan. So we need Ryazan next. It's a vassal of the Great Horde. Okay, let's start building spy network. First we need to cancel this, we have only two diplomats. First we need to build spy network and then we can fabricate the claim, so we have a claim to take from them. We can make states. Maintenance. Oh, let's wait for Novgorod to be finished and then we can go for that option. Now let's pay 90 gold. When can we declare next war on Novgorod? 1462, okay, that's a lot of years. Fabricate claim. What is my network right now? I have 12% and we need 20 and then we can fabricate claim. second diplomat. We can offer alliance. Okay, let's try improve relations with this state and then annex it. Okay, speed is fine. Let's check out the trade. Oh, not getting much. But I have three advisors, that is the problem. Manpower is 22, okay. It's recovering slowly. Okay, we can fabricate coin, Tambu. Okay, looks like we can declare war on them now. Let's wait a few months so we can get some manpower. Our maximum is 23,000. You need manpower to train more units or to reinforce your units who have been in combat. Have separatists boost ability. Okay, looks like military will first go for level 4. November 1452. Should I wait for it? Because units are getting shock and cavalry shock. Morale 2.5, 2.50. Okay, getting 1.77, that's good. Okay, Crimea declared war on the Great Horde, that's good news. Let's see, we have a revolt, 10,000 troops, okay, let's send those 14,000 to deal with the rebels, and then we will declare the war on the Great Horde. Teutonic Order, Livonian Order. Now it would be a good time maybe to declare war on Lithuania. Are we losing that? How? How did you lose that battle? Okay. Tough rebels. The Renaissance. Ah, yeah, I know what is the problem. I did lower the army maintenance. Yeah. Yeah. Unit was not on the full morale, and that is the reason I lost the battle. Great. Okay, let's declare war. We have no diplomats to send. Okay, stop building spy network. Bribes growing more accepted. What is the difference between an honest man and a fool? The fool doesn't know he is being swindled. Gain 0.50 corruption. Okay, you can invest in new technology, let's do that. Military tactics and land morale increased. Okay. Bell's air opinion 30. The new possessor room support the church authorities. 10 loyalty, okay. Let's see, where is that? Now we need to wait for more loyalty, then we can. Oh, I can seize the land. I'm at war. Air falls ill, send for a trained medic, pray for his wife. 50% chance of dying, and he dies. And we don't have an heir? Okay. Great. We are still besieging the capital. Horizon. Minus 21%. And we have a new heir, 262. Okay. Claim 60%, 80. Better stats than the previous one. Grand Knees of Sili II. 312, 26, that's 10, and that is 6. Okay, looks like we occupied everything that I could. Siege Horizon, 390 days, 77%. Okay, 80%. We can take Horizon. Okay, let's take these 6 territories and some goods and demand. Corruption is growing, okay. Take the steps. Okay, looks like we have our rebels. Denmark. Oh well. Thank you. 15 reality. Burgers. Odoyev, subjugation, Cassius Belli. Let's take that one territory for the boyars. The 1462 is the Novgorod War. Take out the sphere as well. Let's see. Or maybe basalize them. The 28%. Administration power. Our mission was to vassalize them. Okay, whatever. 121. Wow. That's a lot. Yeah, let's lower the army maintenance. We are no longer in war. Now we need to make that core. Wait for the manpower and basically do nothing right now. We have unrest. Separatists. Okay, we can annex Basel. Pskov. Okay, diplomatic technology. Denmark, Sweden, and Norway. Technology research uses. They have a point. Ignore them. Prestige. What is our prestige? 35. Okay. Reform. From vassals, autocracy, modifiers, influence. Let's see. Well, this is new. When I played the game like 3 years ago, there was no these options. Modifiers plus 10. Man, what is the influence? Where is that option? Boyars influence 47. Income from vassals 25%, boyar influence 5%. Okay, more money. Yeah, looks like WoW Classic fresh servers are coming soon. I will probably play that fresh server. I would like also to make a guild, and if anyone wants to play with me, we can play together. Okay, we have separatists. Let's move armies. Again, I forgot that I'm not paying my army to the maximum. Do I have any casus belli against them? No. Yeah, we have a peace until 62. Okay, what is the progress of those technologies? Diplomatic. May 1460, 2 years. Administration technology. Alexander Kozo has corrupt connections. Let's see, either gain minus efficiency, and then I need to pay again for a new guy. Naive relative, execute him for treason. Yeah, let's not lose prestige. Did we annex Peskov? Almost. I also should attack Livonia in order. Turn blind eye. 15 loyalty. Loyalty 33%. Okay, I got additional 3,000 troops. Let's wait for Novgorod and then declare war. Sweden is still in personal union. Maybe I should declare war on Denmark and try to liberate Sweden. take out Novgorod, or maybe try to make them a vassal. We also have a Tver, and then maybe try to vassalize Great Horde or Kazan. Now let's improve relations until we can declare war on Novgorod. Maybe Diddley will be free tomorrow, so we could play Burning Crusade Classic. Okay. Maybe we need to destroy a fort or two. That's a good option. I forgot about it. Now forts are not active. Okay, now we are getting some gold. Yeah, Denmark took those territories which I was planning to do, but you can't take everything. Okay, can I upgrade units? How is that working in this game? Click here. Oh, okay. Well, we have a new unit. Eastern Militia and Drusina Cavalry. I need to take out that next. Okay, diplomatic. Can I build marketplace? Maybe we could try vassalizing Livonian Order. I like the music. Hey, Ahmed, yeah, it's a good music. Well, I think all Paradox game has a good music. I think they researched the time period and tried to make the music which fits the game. Oh, this is the 15th century. Oh, yeah. Happening in the 15th century. Okay, land force plus two. Well, 4.35 monthly. I can't pay that. I can go for plus one skill, and that plus one will give me additional one military power per month. And reinforce speed and land force limit modifier. We are not close to the limit modifier. Let's go for reinforce speed. 35 years. Now we have advisors who are giving you different modifiers and they're increasing your power, which are you getting every month. And that power you need for various actions, technologies, and to progress your nation. Administration technology, level 4. You can now build church. Let's see, where is the building option? How do I build in this game? I forgot everything. Let's see, severe winter. Here? Ah, yeah, it's here, okay. A local tax modifier plus 40%. I think you can build like... only few buildings. You can't build everything. But you can build the navy here. Okay, what I'm getting here, how much wealth. Three, okay. Yeah, let's build one church, more money, 40%. Okay, can we declare war on Novgorod? No, we need to wait until July. Okay. Let's increase the army maintenance. We need at the full power. 869. We're still getting one per month. We have rebels. Kazan declared war on Great Horde, that's a good opportunity. But first I need to take out Novgorod and then I can go for maybe Great Horde, try to make them my client state. I just annexed one vassal, his call. Okay, truce has ended. Let's declare war then. I have no diplomats to send. Okay, my diplomats are increasing relations with my vassals. Now we can declare war. Okay, let's attack. I will destroy their army. I'll leave one army here to besiege the province and 3,000. Let's move second army with the general. Now let's follow this army and then let's attack Novgorod army. Your ports are blockaded. Oh no. I'll just ignore it. I don't have any ships. Let's try to capture that army. Oh, by capture I mean encounter them. Okay. Any invasion imminent. Oh well, not important, that's like 1000. Okay, you have 12,000 now. Maybe I should wait for that army to finish besieging in Novgorod and then attack. Yeah, that would be close battle. Difference is like 1000 units. Okay, -7%. Can you join the battle? No, I was too late for that one. Okay, 21%. Okay, so for peace. Now we can take them as the vassal. I became a subject. They have rejected. Okay then. The map is so cool. Ah, good evening to all zone. Yeah, playing this strategy game. It's free to get on the Epic store. For the next 6 days, your open result is 4. You just need to have an account, click on it, and it's your game. If you can't or don't want to play it now, you can play it later. It's 97%. Okay, let's see. Let's try taking Tver as vassal and taking a few territories. Okay, send demand. We got a few territories. And here a new vassal. We can annex this one. With that one, let's see, we don't need forts, so let's stop paying for them. Okay, Great Horde and Kazan are at each other's throat, so we can use that to our advantage to attack. Okay, let's annex one of my vassals, plus 91, plus 192. I will try to make maybe Great Horde my vassal. Okay, we have 54 trade power now, and we are collecting 535. Well, this game is complicated. This is a trade map with trade zones. I have two merchants, and I'm steering my trade to Novgorod. Okay, what's this? Unhappiness among the clergy. Agree to their demands. Let's see. Yeah, we could lower the army maintenance for now. We have 5,000 manpower. What's my unit limit? My unit limit is 29 out of 36. There are also mercenaries if you don't have your own manpower to create. Okay, what they want? They want a church. How to increase base production? Maybe I need to build something. Okay, Vologda, where is that territory? Let's see, what's my production level here? Production 0.15. Local trade power, local tax modifier. $14.84. Let's go with that option and let's build it. Church. They are winning against Kazan. Yeah, I have truce with them. Okay, I'm annexing one state. Should I go for Kazan? They have 35,000, I have 109,000 troops. Or we can wait for that war to be over and then attack. Try to vassalize them. Thank you. Okay, Tambov. Build to the force limit. Okay, let's build to the force limit. We have a mission for that. Okay, I still can't build cannon units. Okay, I can go for 9 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And let's go Druzhina cavalry. Clear war on Kazan. Okay, maybe I can vassalize them now because there was some territory to the Great Horde. What else we can build? Marketplace. Production is still 0.15. Oh, we can spend here. Ah, yeah, yeah, I forgot about this. At the limit, and that is the objective of one mission. Ally with Uzbek only. Yeah, let's take them out. Okay, we lost one advisor. National address -2%. Yeah, we need this guy. Built to the force limit. Morale of the army is 5%, and land maintenance modifier -5. Expand Moscow. I quick to complete this mission. Okay, base tax in Moscow. Local construction. Okay, that's good. What's next? Conquer new states. Has grown by at least 5 states. 5 church and 5 workshop. We need allies. One more advisor has died. Stop dying on me. Plus one. Let's see. Improve relations. Spy network construction. Let's go with improve relations. I'm not building. Well, I'm building. So I need to build spy network here for Livonian order. How goes that annex process? June 1470. Okay, now I've got the bathroom, be right back. Okay, I'm back. Well, this is one of the easiest start in the game. I would say also Ottomans, Castile, maybe France or England. England is still alive. Did they win the war? Okay. I would also like to start playing as England. Try to win 100 year war, but I'm trying to learn the game. So Ottomans, Mamluks also easy start. Okay, let's see. Let's increase arm maintenance. Missionary strength. Do we need a general? We always go one general, 50 military power. They have a lot of territories, maybe I can't vassalize them. Revolt, lower taxes. Now what's lower taxes? My vassals are winning. Yeah, maybe I could vassalize Livonia in order. How is that? Annexation going? Yeah, 1473 more years. I need to increase relations with them. We have the separatist 11,000. Okay, let's send one army to take care of the separatist. Okay, I think that force should hold on by the time I'm there. And that is the unexplored part of the world. Mm-hmm. how much we are losing. 579. Yeah, let's go with 4 taxes. 2 military power per month. Oh, I see, 6,000. Okay, let's send one army. This. Okay, let's attack. There will be a combat. Oh, battle. Now, was it on minus 97? Can I attack there? No. Okay, capital Kazan war objective. You'll get more war score after you capture your objective. My objective is Kazan. Or cousin, however they pronounce it. Okay, now it's 20%. Yeah, war score is only 23% because of their allies, and there are some of their further east. And we have 7,000 troops again from the south. Minus 42%. Accept the petition. 2% of land, 15 loyalty. Yeah, I'm not going to complete that mission. Okay, they're retreating again. Yeah, we've won in order would be better option than these. I'm losing time now and gold. Have now 11,000. Okay, they're moving here. Now let's retreat and wait for second army. Okay, Okay, 41%. Here's the second one. Yeah, the second one was annexing. Okay, let's start with the Livonian Order spy network. Are we going here? Let's try to win one more battle and then take a territory too. I think going for the 100% that would take a lot of time. Ruiz Nations, Kiva, where is Kiva? Yeah. Okay, Pern. Oh, that's good. Pern getting one territory, okay. Okay, Perm got one territory and I take few. Let's see. Empty the forts. Relations with Tver. Maybe next war I could vassalize them. administration, technology, at least 10. Okay, let's see. So we need a technology at 10 to form Russian nation. Okay, great horde again, my vessel. Royal marriage. National manpower mod for 15%. Okay, military 6. We have new cavalry and we now can build barracks. Okay, let's split this army. We haven't taken Livonian order before Denmark declared war again on them. And Denmark just did that. Wait. Yeah, looks like I'm late. I wasted my time on the east. But let's move my troops, maybe I can declare war soon. Okay, 10 loyalty. And we have a revolt. Okay, increase army maintenance. What? Did the general die again? Come on. Okay, let's attack. Yeah, okay, 3,000 troops more, I should be able to defeat them. Clear that war. He's building a spy network, but he can't declare war. Okay, we need war taxes again. And of course there is army from Denmark besieging the capital of Livonian Order. Great. Okay, why don't you go and attack them? Good job. And we have a revolt. Okay, let's send one army back to Kazan. Okay, this is 7%. New technology. New idea. Okay, 21% so far. Now let's take more territory. That one is over. Oh, Okay, we need to empty all forts again. Okay, it's 56% now. Vassal is 61%. If I make them my vassal, would I then be at war against Denmark? That's a good question. What's over the army maintenance? I'm no longer. Well, I'm still at war, but I don't see any of their armies. I think all their armies are defeated. Well, now we have an interesting situation. They can't finish their war because they control most of Livonian order. I would like to know what is the war objective of their war. They have 10,000, you have 19,000, it's 29,000. So it's plus 16, what are you going to do? Are you going to... Okay, they have now 10,000 troops, Teutonic army. Why don't you attack Denmark? Let's see. They have 30,000, besieging one territory. Yeah, I need to increase army maintenance. Your arm. Okay, looks like Teutonic Wars signed the peace with Denmark. Yeah, objective of their war is Livonian Order. Okay, diplomatic. Trade efficiency increased 2%. So Denmark, what are you going to do? Your war score is 19. Ej, pozdrav Trhani, dobrodošao. Well, I'm playing Europa Universalis 4. Right now it's free on Epic Games. Znači odeš na Epic Games, ako imaš nalog, napraviš nalog, klikneš Get Game i to ti to. Besplatno možeš igrati kad hoćeš onda. Znači Epic Games i dobiješ Europa Universalis 4. Ok, we have Rebels. We need to finish this 4. I think I got Civilization maybe for free somewhere. I did play maybe for like a few hours, but I like these games from the Paradox. Europa Universalis, Hearts of Iron, Crusader Kings. I spent thousands of hours playing these games in the last 10 years. Oh, 10,000 troops north. If I vassalize Livonian Order, am I then going to be at war against Denmark? That is the question. Where are you going now? Stay and fight rebels. Allied with Bohemia and Austria, that's a problem. Should I try to make them my vassal? I think they're too far. I want to go in an order. Thank you. Okay, where are you going? Yeah, let's take gold and let's finish this war with Teutonic Order. And now it's 67, yeah, now I have a problem. Because it's 67, I can't make them my vessel. Well, I did save to see what will happen. Okay, let's hold that. Yeah, now we are at war with Denmark. Yeah, I was expecting that. Okay, let's try to defend our new vessel. Let's send one army to defeat those rebels. They're giving good. They're making problems for my vessel. yeah, music is really good. Okay, let's move army, we can leave them here. Okay, 20,000 troops. Okay, let's attack 29,000. Okay, we won the battle. How about white peace? I'm losing gold here. Can't take that. Now we can take some gold, maybe. Okay, I managed to save Livonian Order from the Denmark, got a new vessel. Are you ready to take out Novgorod? And then we could end the tonight. Oh, not bad. I got the Livonian Order. One stability, that's good. Cottage industry, we can stand with the progress. Loyalty, yeah, let's go 15 loyalty, we need more loyalty with the estates. Thank you. Okay, to reinforce my armies, I still need 3,300 rise of a pretender. 21 pretender regiments revolt in Moscow. Okay. A new Grand Knyaz. We have a new ruler. Age 26, we don't have any heir. Okay, do we have a royal marriage? So we have a royal marriage with them. Okay. Hold on! I'm here. Let's stack. Okay, looks like we are done with that event. Let's move them north. Disloyal attitude. Okay, new advisor plus one national manpower modifier. I don't need it, but plus two, I don't have that much gold to pay. So let's go with that guy. Okay, max promote cultures, mount autonomy change, manpower. Yeah, we need to pay a war on Novgorod. I have 6,000, so let's just try to finish them. Take Ladoga. Okay, we have a new heir, 441, not bad. Strong claim, age 0, 262, that's 10 points. Air has 9 points, not bad. Let's see if we can finish with Novgorod. Poland, Allied, yeah, Bohemia and Austria, that's a problem. Next, let's see, I could maybe annex one of my vassals. Yeah, Poland is expanding into Hungary, Serbia is still alive, Byzantine Empire no more, Moldavia is annexed. You have 3,000 troops. Tomorrow I will either continue playing this or maybe play with Didui if he's free to play tomorrow. I have to do something. Okay, spend some gold. 82%, almost done. And again, can take everything. Okay, transfer trade power. How much gold do we have? Thank you. No, let's take it. One more war, and then Novgorod is going to be annexed. That war will be 1496. So that's 13 years old. He suffers. Truce lasting. Improve relations, and then we could maybe annex them. Yeah, they are the order. Can't enter the royal marriage. Yeah, we can lower army maintenance for now. Okay, artillery at the level 7. Holy person has arrived. Oh, not bad, 2.4. Cheap, and getting additional. Yeah, let's remove that guy. We need more administrative power for more reforms. No, next option is Kazan again. Try to vassalize them. Our great horde. Okay, what can we build here? Marketplace, army, manpower modifier plus 50%. What is manpower modifier? Where I can see that. Intrigues in Moscow. Skill 2. Forty-four, 46. Okay, let's see. They want, what do they want? Stability, level 3. They want one province in Estonia owned by Moscow. Let's see, base production 5. Stability at least 3. Okay, let's increase stability to 3. We can govern that much. Rostov, I was declining it. I want to annex them. We can now build a dock, dockyard. Okay, now we can build cannons. Okay, now we have rebels. Yeah, bad call. I'm guessing they'll keep on revolting until I get that above 30%. Okay, I'm going to annex Rostov, then attack Kazan, and maybe try to vassalize them. Crimea and Uzbek. Okay, that is 30%, and that is 30%. Okay, that is good now. Okay. Holy Roman Empire, yeah. Nothing with me. How goes Rostov? And we have the separatist in Kazan. Great. Let's pay for those 13,000. Great, Horde clear war on Kazan. Oh, that's not a good news. Maybe we need clear war on Great Horde again. And we can empty our forts again. Okay, we have a trader level 2. 2.46 mountain. Okay, let's go take Bulgar. Army maintenance is at the maximum. Okay, continue pushing south. Okay, let's attack those 4,000s. Attack those 3,000. Okay, it's 51 now. Okay, marketplace, let's check out trade. Okay, that's enough. Marketplace will increase the trade power. You should build it where the trade route is passing. Okay, 64%. Have them north. Okay, let's send one army north. Defend Rostov. Looks like I'm going to help save out Kazan for myself. I can declare war and vassalize them. After I'm done with Rostov annexation. What is my army limit? $45, $42, Rising support among the Rhysian population. Rhysian, okay. Okay, 97%. Šta da se igra? Se igra ovaj... Burning Crusade Classic ili da se igra ova igra? Za obje da igre treba puno vremena. Okay, looks like there will be a coalition against me. What ongoing battles minus 37? Okay, took two territories, send them out. Noble families. Okay, let's end the stream here. 3 hours. Yeah, I had fun. I like playing these games. Not bad. Next war, we are going to finish Novgorod. Let's see, we have 4 vassals. No, 3. 4 Perm, Belozer, Livonian Order, and Tver. Maybe I could declare war on Kazan and try to make them my vassal next time. Also, we need to start doing something about Poland. Bohemia, Austria, yeah, those are the strong states. Bohemia and Poland are bordering, but they like each other. Interesting. So Austria is a rival of Bohemia, but Poland is ally both to Bohemia and Austria. Okay, well, end the stream. Tomorrow I will either continue playing this save game or maybe play Burning Crusade Classic with Didui. I don't know if he's free to play tomorrow. Terhanis was here, Mr. Azon, Ahmed and Kusuru. Thank you for stopping by. This game is free to get on Epic Games for the next 6 days.